Welcome to SciPride 2020, the virtual edition. My name is Holly Menninger, and I'm the Director of Public Engagement and Science Learning at the Bell Museum. We are proud to be Minnesota State Natural History Museum, and as well as a gateway to research at the University of Minnesota. In honor of Pride Month in June, the Bell Museum, in partnership with the College of Food, Agriculture, and Natural Resource Sciences, the College of Science and Engineering's Collegiate Life Office, Diversity and Inclusion, and Market Science with the College of Biological Science, will be celebrating the scientific contributions of the LGBTQ plus community at the University of Minnesota. I'd like to introduce my two colleagues and co-organizers for SciPride 2020, Dr. Jim Bradeen and Dr. Alan McCormick. Take it away.
Thank you, Holly, and hello, everyone. Happy Pride. I'm delighted to add my welcome to SciPride, sponsored by the Bell Museum. I'm professor and department head of plant pathology here at the U. I'm a proud gay scientist, and I use he, him pronouns. SciPride started last year to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the Stonewall riots. Stonewall was a galvanizing point in the history of the LGBT plus community, a point in time when we had had enough of harassment and discrimination from the police, from civic and political leaders, and from society at large. The brave individuals who stood up for the rights at Stonewall and the many brave individuals since who have demanded equality, respect, and visibility in their daily lives have paved the way for the rights of the LGBTQ community that we enjoy today. We owe each of these individuals our gratitude. SciPride 2020 comes amidst a global pandemic and at a time when, as a society at large, we again grapple with issues of equality, diversity, and respect. The death of Minneapolitan George Floyd at the hands of the Minneapolis police has galvanized our society here in the state of Minnesota and across the nation, resulting in riots and protests. As we celebrate LGBT plus Pride this year, I am reminded how far we have come as a broader society and how much work there is left to be done. I am thankful for all who have stood up for justice and to support community in its many forms. I'm also thankful for the LGBT plus scientists and engineers who are presenting as part of SciPride 2020. Your visibility as authentic LGBT plus professionals in the STEM fields underscores that you can, in fact, be a fantastic scientist or a fantastic engineer and true to yourself. Finally, I want to thank the Bell Museum and the University of Minnesota for sponsoring SciPride 2020. Happy Pride, everyone. Alan.
Hello, everybody. I'm Alan McCormick, he, him pronouns, and I teach as an out gay man in chemical engineering and material science at the University of Minnesota. I'm so impressed with the wonderful presentations by LGBTQ plus scientists and engineers from the university. And I'm very grateful to the presenters. While the climate is getting better in STEM fields, it is still difficult in some areas for gender diverse and sexuality diverse people to be out and or feel fully safe or included. It's an important message to everyone to see out LGBTQ plus STEM visibility. It's important to people who are already out. It's important to people who may not be able to be out but are helped by the validation. It's important to people who want to act as allies. And it's also important to people who need some education about LGBTQ plus people and our presence in STEM. Thanks very much. Holly?
Thank you both, Jim and Alan. We encourage you to watch and share the outstanding videos and presentations by our LGBTQ plus STEM researchers here at the University of Minnesota. Please use the hashtag SciPride. Take good care and happy Pride.